In this illustration, we'll study about the impulse by a string on a moving particle. Here we are given that the figure shows two equal mass particles A and B attached by a string of length 2L and placed on a smooth horizontal table at separation L. Here it is saying if B is imparted a speed u horizontally normal to line AB, then we are required to find the velocity of each particle just after a string becomes taut. So, in this situation here we can see when the particle B moves, the string becomes tight when the length of this line AB will be 2L. This would be the situation if this is the particle A and at a distance L, if this is the position of B and it moves, then it will become tight. The string will become tight when this length will be 2L, that is the length of a string. So, in this situation, if this angle is theta, as soon as the string becomes tight, the tension in a string imparts an impulse J on the two particles in opposite direction. So, as it was moving with a speed u, just after this impulse, its velocity along the string and perpendicular to a string, we can analyze if these velocities are V1 and V2. And here we can see if this angle is theta, this is also theta. So, this impulse will change the velocity component along the length of a string. And when it becomes tight, ball A also moves with the velocity V1 just when it becomes tight. So, here in solution we can write, just after a string becomes tight, we use, if we talk about along the length of a string, then here we can write for particle A. Initially it was at rest, so for this we can write J is equals to mv1 because J is the impulse which imparts at the velocity v1. And similarly we talk for B, before a string becomes tight it was moving in this direction with the velocity u cos theta, and in this direction we can consider its velocity was u sin theta. So, here we can write its momentum impulse equation as mu cos theta minus j is equals to mv1. From here, you can see we substitute the value of j over here. This equation results mu cos theta is equals to 2mv1, where m gets cancelled out. This will result the value of v1, which is half u cos theta. And now, if we talk in the direction perpendicular to the line of a string, as no impulse is there on it, we can write along the direction perpendicular to length of a string. Here we can write its initial momentum was mu sin theta, and as no impulse is imparted, this must be same as mv2. This implies we are getting the velocity component perpendicular to string direction that remains same, which is u sin theta. And here we can see the value of sin theta is equals to l by 2l, it is 1 by 2. So, the value of theta we take as 30 degree. So, on substituting the values, we are getting V1 and V2. So, in this situation, we can write final velocities for A. We can write it is V1 only, that is equals to half u cos 30 degree. We can write as root 3 by 2, so the result is root 3 by 4 u. That is one result of the problem. And for particle B, we can write its final velocity is root of v1 square plus v2 square. So, on substituting the values, this will be root of this V1 square will be 3 by 16 U square plus V2 square, this is U by 2. So, this is 1 by 4 U square. So, on simplifying this, we are getting this as root 7 by 4 U. That is another result of the problem. So, these are the velocities of balls, the particles A and B just after a string becomes tight.